Hi, my name is Lee, and I'm the director of the IBM Planning Analytics team here at Revelwood. Today, I'm going to show you some approaches of how to filter your elements when defining a subset in the Planning Analytics editor. So I'm going to edit my set, and in this particular case, I'm going to edit the department dimension. I'm simply going to double-click on it to bring me into set editor. Okay. When I look at my set editor, I'm going to start by saying, show me all my members. And what I have the ability to do is I have the ability to do filtering. And I can filter by clicking on this icon that says filter. So by clicking on the icon brings me to a pop-up window where I can start filling in the values. I can look at the name, I can look at the level, I can look at various other components. When I'm looking at it, I could say contains, I could say equal, I could say start with. These concepts give us the ability to eliminate the old approach of using the asterisk. Star XYZ means find me anything that ends in XYZ. XYZ star means find me anything that has XYZ at the beginning. By using this as words, takes that approach out. And if I'm looking at all my elements, maybe I want to do something where I'm just going to filter down and say, show me all the elements that have media. I'm going to say name contains media. I click on done. And now my subset is filtered down to just those two elements. If I say that's not what I wanted, I also have the ability to reset by clicking on the icon that looks like an arrow going around to the left, reset my filters, brings me back to my starting point. So what I can also do within my filters is I could click on the filter. I could say, okay, I want my name to be media. I'm gonna say, choose media. I say done, brings me down to my two elements. Now what I can also do is I could filter even further and I could say, I wanna create another filter. I want to use the word new. When I say done, it filters what was remaining. Brings me down piecemeal, one at a time. Similar in nature to the legacy tool. Paw allows you to expand that a little further. So I'm going to reset. I'm going to go back to my filter. And instead of setting it up where I have to go one at a time, I can now say name contained media. And instead of clicking on done, I could say I want to add a second filter. So when I add the second filter, I could also say, now I want the name to contain new. And when I click on done, it's going to bring up both of these filters as a single approach. And depending on the version that you have, version 76 also introduces the ability when I'm putting in media, I can click on add, I can go into new. Version 76 gives us the ability to determine, do I want to match all of the following? Think of it like an and. Or do I want to match any of the following? Think of it like an or. In this particular case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the example a little bit. I'm going to change it to match any of the following. And instead of looking up media and new, I'm going to look up media and I'm just going to use part of advertising, ADV. By having the two of these pieces, by having it also say match any of the following, when I click on done, not only do I get my two elements that had media, but I also get my advertising element. Thanks for watching the video. I hope it helped you learn more about Planning Analytics. Please visit our website at revelwood.com to learn more about us and how we can help you enhance your Planning Analytics experience.